There are many popular Linux distributions out there. I'm sure all of them try to present something exciting every year. However, personally, I feel that some of them stand out among others with their development progress, feature additions, and improvements. This is Ankush from It's First, and here I am going to tell you about the best 7 Linux distributions to look forward to in 2021. Do note, this is completely my opinion. Feel free to share what you're excited about in the comments down below. So first up is Elementary OS 6. Elementary OS 6 is undoubtedly an exciting upcoming release in 2021. It is going to be based on Ubuntu 20.04 LTS, and you can expect all the same goodies that you get with Ubuntu. With Elementary OS 6, they are focusing on a much more improved user experience, not just limited to a seamless dark mode experience, but you can expect a lot of attention to details. Of course, it is already one of the best beautiful Linux distributions out there, and the next upgrade could be a huge improvement over that. Also, some impressive multi-touch gestures will be introduced, which should be incredibly useful for trackpad users. In addition to this, you should check out their official blog posts before the release for more details. Next is Garuda Linux. You can find plenty of Arch-based distributions, but Garuda Linux caught our attention last year with an interesting theme in the KD Plasma edition. Not just limited to that, you will also find a couple other interesting editions of Garuda Linux. Considering that it is a fairly new distribution, they seem to have made a good start. The distribution offers plenty of pre-installed tools to make things easy and seems to work as well for many users. So it will be definitely exciting to see what they plan for 2021. My third pick for this list would be ZoroOS. ZoroOS is an impressive Linux distro. For every release, they also offer a light edition, which is often a great candidate for our list of lightweight Linux distributions. Not much is known about ZoroOS 16, but it will be based on Ubuntu 20.04 LTS. You can also expect significant improvements to the user experience while they focus on making it seamless for a former Windows user to get used to it in no time. In addition to that, while going through the official forums, it is evident that they plan to have an upgrade path from ZoroOS 15 to 16 this time. So you can easily upgrade from ZoroOS 15 without needing to reinstall the OS. Ubuntu 21.04 is definitely yet another significant release that you should look for in 2021. It should give you an idea for what you can expect with the next LTS release, that is Ubuntu 22.04. Of course, GNOME 40 was expected to arrive with Ubuntu 21.04, but considering that it is going to be a major overhaul in terms of workflow and user interface, they will stick with GNOME 3.38. Even though it could have been the most exciting change, it will be still interesting to see what improvements or tweaks they go for with GNOME 3.38. In addition to that, it is highly likely that you'll see Linux kernel 5.10 powering the distro. Not to forget, it will be also interesting to see the home directory made private in Ubuntu 21.04. Next, my favorite, Popos 21.04. Considering that Ubuntu 21.04 is going to be an interesting release even without GNOME 40, it'll be definitely worth waiting for Popos 21.04. Generally, Popos tries to go a step further and add unique features to improve the workflow as seen in Popos 20.04. So I'm curious how they plan to do it this time without including GNOME 40. Would they add vanilla GNOME 40 with Popos 21.04? Or stick to the current layout of GNOME 3.38, just like Ubuntu 21.04? Or you can expect their unique set of customization and options as well. Let's hope for the best. Not to forget, one of the most anticipated distributions in 2021, Rocky Linux. After CentOS was killed and replaced by CentOS Stream, the original creator of CentOS immediately came up with a new project idea, Rocky Linux. Rocky Linux aims to be the downstream of RHEL, Red Hat Enterprise Linux, just as CentOS was meant to be. So just like CentOS, this aims to be the community version of RHEL developed by the community. Even though there's no specific ETA of the release, but in an official update in their forums, a timeline of around quarter 2 2021 was given to expect its first release. I'm definitely looking forward to that one. Finally, my last pick for this list would be Alma Linux. Alma Linux is a distribution developed by Cloud Linux. It's still a work in progress, just like Rock Linux. Cloud Linux OS is already a quite popular choice by various hosting services. While they already have the infrastructure needed to create a new CentOS alternative, it will be definitely interesting to see what they come up with. Of course, it will be yet another downstream to RHEL, but unlike Rocky Linux, the team behind Alma Linux may have an edge for investments and support for its development. As per their official website, it aims to offer a seamless experience to switch from CentOS. Not much is known about it, but we do have an expected timeline of quarter 1 2021 for its first release. So there we have some of the most anticipated Linux distributions that you should look forward in 2021. Which Linux distribution are you looking forward to in 2021? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And that's all for this video. See you in the next one.